Welcome back. Today, I'm reading you another Shimmer and Shine story called A Tale of Two Genies. A Tale of Two Genies, adapted by David Lehman, illustrated by Dave Alkins. It was a beautiful morning in Zarmay Falls. Shine jumped out of bed. She couldn't wait to start her magical day. Woohoo! She cheered. Nuh-huh, my sweet little tiger. Do you know what today is? Nuh-huh yawned. It's a day my twin sister, Shimmer, and I become genies, Shine explained. Well, more like genies in training. We finally get to grant wishes for our new friend. I'm so excited. The sleepy tiger crawled back under the covers. Come on, Shine instincted. Let's go. Let's go. Wake up, Shimmer. But Shimmer wasn't in her bed. She wasn't under her vanity table. She wasn't in her water bowl closet. Where in the genie world did she go again? Shine asked. Come on, Nuh-huh. Let's look downstairs. In the living room, Shine spotted a collection of pretty genie bottles. Suddenly, one began to shake. Out popped Shimmer and her pet monkey, Tala. What's with all the bottles, sis? Shine asked. I'm looking for the perfect one to give it our new friend, said Shimmer explained. Shine laughed. We can't use just any old genie bottle. We have to make a new one with super special ingredients. Shine clapped her hands. The genie's magic carpet appeared, and off they went to find their special ingredients. The first thing the genies need was to find the bottle with the flower petal. But the genies couldn't pluck the petal. They had to patience and wait for it to drop on its own. As Genie in Training explained, Shimmer, we might made mistakes, so we're going to need a friend with a lot of patience. Finally, a blue petal fell from the flower, and Shine placed it in a glittery box. One flower petal. Check, Shimmer said. Now for the fun part. With that, they flew off on their magic carpet to find the next ingredient. Making sandcastles at the beach sure is fun, Shine said. Exactly, Shine agreed. And our new friend should be just as fun. That's why we'll be adding these fun beach memories to our genie bottle. Shimmer magically sent the whole sandcastle into a jar. They had their second ingredient. The genies hopped on their magic carpet and flew into the air, right through a cloud. The cloud was, we just flew. Whoa, exclaimed Shine. That cloud we just flew through looks like a kind of heart. That's right, Shimmer said, grabbing some of the cloud. And we need a puff on this heart-shaped cloud to match our friend's big, kind heart. The magic carpet dove and landed in the ocean. With a splash, Shimmer and Shine used their carpet like a surfboard to ride their waves. Surfing takes a lot of bravery, Shimmer said. And our new friend has to be brave, too. Using an eyedropper, Shimmer collected the next special ingredient. A little bit of the big ocean wave. The genies and their pets soared through the magical garden of hanging stars. We need to find the most ukulele star we have ever seen, Shimmer said. Something one of a kind, just like our friend should be. Tala pointed to a pink and blue star. There! That's the one, Shine said. They plucked the star from a vine. Now they got all the ingredients. Let's go mix it together, Shimmer said. Back at the palace, Shine put the ingredients into a bowl one by one. She added a little glitter to make the bottle really sparkle. Shine clapped her hands, and a new beautiful bottle appeared. Shimmer and Shine magically turned the star into a stopper. Then the genies shrank the bottle down to make it just the right size for a necklace charm. It was perfect, but who will they give it to? The twins will ask to the magic mirror. The mirror spun around and around until it showed the perfect friend for them. Someone patient, fun, kind-hearted, brave,
and unique.
The genies used their magic mirror to send the genie ball into the human world. It attached itself to a necklace in a carnival booth. At the carnival booth, a girl named Leah knocked over some milk bottles with the ball. We have a winner, the man at the booth announced. And what would the lucky winner like for a prize? Leah wanted the necklace, but her best friend, Zach, said, "Ooh, get the walkie-talkies," giggling. Leah agreed. The man is in charge of the game. Was impressed that Leah had chosen a prize for her friend, so he let her pick out another prize. Leah, choose the pretty necklace. You know, I don't think I ever seen this prize here before. The man said, hang it to her. Maybe there are genies inside. That's silly, Leah said. There are no such thing as genies. Leah went over to the funhouse. She laughed at her reflection in the funny mirrors. She noticed that the bottle on her new necklace, was glowing. Even thought, she knew genies weren't real. She was curious. Then she rubbed the bottle, colorful smoke and sparkle swirled out of it. What's happening? She said. Poof! Leah couldn't believe her eyes. Two girls, a little monkey, and a baby tiger were standing before her. Shimmer and Shine hugged Leah tightly. It's so nice to finally meet you. Shine bubbled. Yeah, you too, said Leah, confused. Who are you?
I'm Shimmer, said the girl with the shiny pink ponytail.
I'm Shine, said the one with the big blue lavender eyes. Together, they climbed. We're your genie's divine. We're here to grant your 3 wishes a day, Shine explained.
There's no way you are real genies, Leah said.
We are, Shimmer said. We'll show you, Shine said, smiled. Using their genie magic, Shimmer and Shine made skateboards, sundaes, and a treehouse appeared out there thin air. Now do you believe us? Shine asked. Leah was amazed.
Yes, she cried. The sisters jump and high five. Zara slam! That means awesome in genie, Shine explained. Leah laughed and hugged the genies. I'm so lucky to have my very own genies, Shimmer said. You're patient, fun, kind-hearted, brave, and unique, Shine added. So, we're the lucky ones to have you. A Tale, Two Genies, The End. Hope you like this video. Give a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. I wonder what story is next time. See you.